Today we learn self-practice at point 1b using the textbook. This is page 218, question 1. 今天我们就看课本的 self-practice 8.1b, page 218, 第一题。今天我们学 stand and leaf plot. Today we learn stem and leaf plot. What is stem and leaf plot? Stem and leaf.是什么意思呢 ？Stem 在华语里面是树枝、树干 ，leaf 是叶子。A stem and leaf plot is a special table where each data value is split into a stem. This is the first digit, and a leaf usually is the last digit. 通常这个 stem 跟 leaf 呢，它是分是坐在一个表格里面。然后他会把那个号码分成前面一部分 stem, 后面那个号码是 leaf. So for example, 32. So 2 is leaf. 32, 2, 最后一组号码，最后一个号码，我们是叫做 leaf. And the in front digit is called stem. 那么前面的一个号码我们叫十位数嘛，叫做 stem.So now we want to split this data into stem and leaf plot. 现在我们要把这一组资料分散，把它排进这个 stem 跟 leaf plot 里面。So we see stem is the front digit. Stem 是我们前面的号码嘛。So our stem have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is stem.Our stem, 我们的 stem 有一、有二、有三，还有四。How about our leaf? Leaf is the last digit. 叶子就是我们最后的一个号码，就是我们的个位数。So this is leaf. So 15, 1, 5. Stem is 1. My leaf is 5. So 15, 16.Okay, 21, 22, 26, 26, 32, so 41. So this is how the stem and leaf plot, 这个叫做 stem 跟 leaf plot 来的。Key, 那么我要写的资料是 if 1/5,That means is 15. 1/5代表是15. Okay, remember, leaf digit 就是这里的号码 This set of data must be arranged from the smallest value to the largest value. 这一组的号码一定要从小排到大 This one must be start from the small to the bigger one. Remember?记得 your leaf must be start from small value to large value. 记得你的叶子一定是要由小的号码排到大的号码。So we look at question 1 in our textbook. The data below shows the measures in kg of 2 groups of pupils. Draw a stem and leaf plot to show the distribution of measures of the 2 groups of pupils.Just now, I show one group data only. 刚才我只是放一组号码罢了。可是现在有两组号码。Now, we have two group data. Previously, I show you one group data only. So now, how we draw the stem and leaf plot for the two group data? So, I will divide it into two. Okay, group A and group B.This center is our stem. Before we draw, determine the stem, we need to go to group A, find the lowest value. So 41 is the smallest value. And I want to go to find the largest value. 我也是要去找它最大的号码。And same with the group B. 同样 group B 也是要找最小和最大。So Now we can determine the stem. Stem is the front digit. Stem 就是我们前面的号码嘛。So the smallest stem is 4, is it? So 最小的 stem 是 4, 最大的 stem 是 8. Okay? The smallest is 4, the largest stem is 8. This one 8. Okay? So now we write down the stem. Start from 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 because our largest value is B.Until 84, so until 8 only. So now I drew the group A first. Still remember, this is leaf. 这里是我们的叶子，这里也是我们的叶子。Okay, this is leaf. Remember, the value of the leaf must start from the smallest value to largest value. 记得我们的叶子一定是要从小排到大。So now I start with the 58.So I write down 5 at. Remember, your stem is 5, your leaf is 8. 47, stem is 4, leaf is 7. 68, do you see that? 63, here is 8. So I move my 8. So 3 must be in front. 61, same. 61, so I move 3 at. So 61, I.Arrange it accordingly. Okay, 我把它先顺着排。So 60, Okay, so you will see that I arranged the data follow the leaf must follow the smallest to the largest. 你会发现呢，老师在做这个的时候，我就已经开始排从小到大了那个叶子。Okay, so during you write in your exercise book, during you write the answer, maybe you can write the difference between the two digits you give a largest distance. 你给他们比较大的空间，到时候那么这些种空间里面，你就可以把小的数目排在前面。Okay, this is the first way I do. I arrange it when I write down the leaf one by one. 我先排好，跟着次序。Okay, second method. I don't arrange the leaf first.I just follow 72, 54, 76, 49, 64, 58, 76, 40. So you will find, you will realize that the number on the leaf for group B I didn't arrange first.这个是第二个方式 This is the second method 这个是第二个方式老师没有先把它们顺序的排好先我只是把我的 leaf 拆出来 I don't arrange the leaf accordingly from the smallest to largest I just separate the stem and the leaf first At the end, until I complete 直到我做完了，我才把它重新排过。Until the end, after I complete, separate the stem and the leaf, I just arrange it again. So you will see that the leaf didn't arrange accordingly. 你会发现这些叶子都没有跟着次序排。So now, I go to arrange. Okay, so this is the new shape that I use. 新的一面就是说我重新把这个东西重新排。So I arrange this.Accordingly, from small to larger. 所以我现在才重新把它排过。So, I arrange it. Same. All must start from the small value to the largest value. So, which method you prefer is depend to you. 你喜欢哪一个方式，那是你的选择。For me, I would prefer the second method. Because if I...Use first method, I need to erase it and then write one more time. It depends to you which one you love it. Okay. So, now we go to second question. Comment on the distribution of the masses of the two groups. Now I want to know. I need to write something. How about the distribution of the masses of the two groups? Okay, we see the group A. 现在我要做这两组来做比较，他们到底我可以从这组的资料里面看到什么？ So you will see that the group A almost all of them is 60 kilo, 70 kilo. More student is have a heavy mass. We see this one. More of the group B pupils is at the range of 40 plus 50 plus. So we can make the conclusion. 我们就可以说 in general, the body mass of pupils in A group A is greater than the body mass of pupils in group B. 因为很多人都是60 70 80 kg 嘛，这里比较多人是50跟40嘛，所以 group A 的重量的学生会比较大，相较于 group B 的学生。 So you can try the homework of page 106 section A. 你可以试着做106的作业里面的 section A 的题目。